Right, since this is what is this, America the Great, I will impart my knowledge here specifically of the system in England involving the health care. Now, when you have the older persons, elderly people, and they're getting very aged, they have something called it's not assisted living. I'm not going to call it this ridiculous word. It's just like a housing type of facility. And they all go into it. I'll try to show you here. They all go into this like building. And it's like, we'll call it an apartment. All right. So in this apartment, they have like buffet food. They have games. They have television. They have sports and hobbies. They have outings, excursions from this building. They have freedom also. They can leave the building when they want, and they can return. Specific hours, of course, not late, too late. They cannot have animals, though. Unless they had one before, they can bring one animal, like a cat or a dog. But they cannot get another. They cannot have a replacement animal, which I think is a wrong system. But they cannot have the replacement animal, and many people die there in this particular building. All right, so they have this building, and they die there also. But they still like their life at this moment. They meet many people. They're living in the fascination of, this is great, I'm having a wonderful conversation with you. And they talk about their children much. Oh, my child did this, and oh, my child did that, and this other one did this other thing. And they yap about their children. And it's almost as if they have to have this moment in their life where they have to yap badly, meanly, atrociously about their children. I'm not sure the reason or the why, but many of them end up in this, it's like a sitcom moment where they just have to just trash their children. You know what I'm saying? Just terrible, terrible little beast that they created out of their, what do we call it? You know, their marriages. Or non. So this is called, I'm not really sure what they call it, but everybody gets it. In England, every person who is English or lived there long enough, they get access to this building to live in and die in. And it doesn't cost very much money at all. It's like the regular normal rent, but like one half or even a third of normal rent, depending upon who you are. And so, if they had created like some kind of a social security, if they had created just a minimal, if they were a little teacher for like 3 years, they get access to this building. Everybody gets access to this building. If they did not have enough money and they did not even work as a little teacher for 3 years, they still get like a scholarship payment. They are paid to live in this building. So somebody pays their rent. Okay, so everybody is provided for in their old age. This is a United Kingdom system, and it is not $5,000 a month. They call it here in the United States called assisted living. It is not, oh my God, they lost their memory, so that's an extra $1,000. No, it is not that system at all. It's $5,000 not. So anyway, so that's where we're at here in America. We're looking at this $5,000 per person who's old, assuming, oh my gosh, they don't concentrate well. Yeah, you're all $5,000 a pop, you know what I'm saying? Pretty expensive. So anyway, I support, after this conversation, I support, what do they call it? A national health system, national health security, you know, that thing where it's, it's like allowed for these old people to go to. Because as it is at this moment in time, it is not. It's not an allowable deal. It's pretty tragic. So, how do I fix that? I don't know. I just can impart to you what the deal is, you know, how it's done there, and you know, maybe enlighten you guys. And they call it the National Health Service, and then people complain about it all the time. But in the light of everything, the old people are provided for at the end. And maybe that's it. Maybe that's all we're supposed to do, is have some kind of a system where the old people are provided for at the end, so that their young don't have to end up in this in any type of situation of carriage or keep extra and over an abundance than normal. All right. So there. Yeah, I don't know how. What do we call that? A national, a prepaid health system? I think it's a prepaid health system. Yeah. So anyway, so that's what I'm supporting, and I know it costs a lot of money. Apparently, it costs money out of the taxpayers' dollars. I believe in Britain, your taxations are close to 25% to 35%. And a lot of that is, you know, out there paying this national health system. So that is the take difference, is you are taking from that taxation of through the life to make sure your children and the others, any others, do not have to, you know, look after you. You have your own situation. And it's a respectable situation, I believe so. All the persons I've ever known that have gone to these have seemed very happy. They've been like, this is the best time ever I've had in my entire life. So the only difference is they have to take, you know, get away from their houses and their luxuries of apartments and downsize. So that's my big... a big gluttony in politics today. That's all I have to say, is I guess so. I support the national health system of Britain, even. That would be a good thing here for the United States of America.